Hello and welcome to my channel. I am Savita. As I had mentioned earlier in one of my videos, I get lot many puja cabinet orders these days. So today I am going to show you how you can transform an arma dresser into a puja mandir. The customer bought this arma dresser from Facebook marketplace and dropped it in my garage to transform it into a puja mandir. If you are also looking for an arma cabinet, I strongly recommend you to look at Facebook marketplace. A solid arma cabinet can be anywhere between $50 to $100. If you are lucky, you might even find it for free in Craigslist. So before going into the video, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for notification.
This is the arma with two drawers and beautiful doors. It is a good size for bigger homes with lots of storage. The customer has asked for bells to be hung on the doors and a two-level gopuram on the top. I'm given a free hand to choose the colors, but the customer was very particular that the door should be blue. There is one more drawer inside the door. Before starting to paint, I have to remove these partitions. It is quite easy to remove the partition, but after that I have filled the holes using wood filler. I have already cut circular shaped holes on the doors for hanging the bells, but I missed to record it. I will make a separate video on how to cut holes and hang bells in detail. I have also made the gopuram for the cabinet. This is a two-level gopuram. If you are interested, I have made a detailed video on making a single-level gopuram and the link is in the description box. I am done with all the woodwork needed and cleaned it. Now it is all ready to be painted. I always start painting from the insides and for this project I have picked orange. I normally choose pumpkin from Waverly or Monarch from Folkart, but unluckily both of them were out of stock. So I ordered a new brand which I had never used before. But this paint did not apply well and the coverage was very bad even after 3 coats. So I decided to change it to red instead. The customer was very particular about one shade of blue, that is Blue Iris from Debbie's DIY. You can buy this paint only from the stockist or from Debbie's DIY website. If you want to buy this paint, I recommend you to buy from nearby stockist so that you can avoid a heavy shipping cost. The customer has asked me to use bright colors like green, orange, yellow and red. So I have used Gritto from Folkart for green for all the drawers and the bottom portion of the sides. For the top and bottom trims I have painted red and for the side edges of the front side I have used yellow. The trims between the drawers I have chosen orange. I had only a little quantity of orange left from Waverly and was able to use it here. I have applied 2 coats of all the colors and the base painting is complete. The customer has also asked design patterns to be embossed on the rectangular portion at the bottom of the door. So I made these pieces using paper clay and painted it red. For this you will need a silicone mold and paper clay. Take a small amount of paper clay and spread it evenly on the mold. It can be easily removed from the mold by slightly bending the silicone mold and then allow it to dry. You can buy this from Amazon. I have given the link in the description box. You can also use molds that are meant for cake decorations. I have chosen a peacock feature stencil since the customer was asking for something like it. The customer was not particular about the colors. I imagine overlaying green over blue using the stencil will reflect the actual colors on a peacock feather. But I realized green did not contrast well with blue. So, using a white acrylic marker pen, I have outlined the stencil. I had explained in one of my previous videos about different techniques that I use on motifs. The link is in the description box. I have also used a gold acrylic pen to highlight the patterns. Now I feel it stands out much better. Since I had only a few stencils for borders, I bought this from Amazon and the link is in the description box. I am happy that the stencil and design patterns turned out quite beautiful. For the insides, I have used mandala pattern stencil. The customer has asked for an Om symbol to be painted using Tamil letters, which is a language spoken in state of Tamil Nadu in India. So I have stenciled only the outer part of the mandala and left the center part blank for the Om symbol. I was not able to find a Om stencil in Tamil, so I had do it freehand. I knew it would not come out perfect, but still gave it a try and the customer was okay with this. The customer asked for Sikku column designs to be painted on some part of the cabinet and I have decided to do it on the drawers and the hanging beer on the inside wall. The door was not looking good without any motifs on it. So I did a combination of Sikku column motifs and some stencil work on the inside and outside of the doors. Without a golden touch, puja cabinets will look incomplete. So I have added a touch of gold wherever appropriate. I have completed painting the cabinet and starting to paint the gopuram now. I have used the same combination of three colors, red, green and blue as in the cabinet. The painting is complete and now I am attaching the finials using E6000 glue after it was spray painted in cool. For the finishing coat, I have used water-based polyurethane for all the parts of the cabinet. On some cabinets, I use clear wax for the outsides. I chose the finishing coat depending on the type of finish I want to give. This finishing coat protects the paint and adds durability. Once the polyurethane coat has dried, I used gold rub and buff for the gopuram for the rich look. Finally, I have attached the bells and the handles for the doors and the drawers. The brass handles were black due to oxidization and I have washed them to give a fresh look. The inside of the cabinet and the gopuram are wired with LED lights, which makes it look amazing under dim light. Now the cabinet is all done and ready to go to its new home. For more painting ideas and tips, watch my other videos also. In every video, I give some tips and tricks for painting. These ideas need not be limited to puja cabinets. You can use these ideas even for painting other furnitures like coffee tables, dressers, sideboards or TV cabinets. It's up to your imagination. Leave your comments and suggestions in the comment box. See you next week with one more interesting video. Thank you.